And now, the DuPont Show of the Week.
Good evening. I'm Garry Moore, and this is Chicago, the capital of the land of jazz in the 20s. For about 10 years, you could hear more exciting music there than any other place in the country. It's a fascinating story. Tonight, a lot of the jazz greats of the Chicago days are going to show us what Chicago jazz really was like. And at the end of the show, there's going to be a jazz free-for-all that's liable to blow you right out of your living rooms. So hold on to your hats. Here we go to the land of jazz.
This ain't to do the land of jazz. Want to hear the kind of blues Chicago has?
I want to step to the tune that's full of ginger and pep. Pick them up and lay them down.
Learn to do the rest of the jazz. Let me give you a warning. Won't get home until morning.
Cause this night's full of jazz, so in the loving land of jazz.
The music was changing now in the middle 20s. The New Orleans style, so easy and relaxed and elegant, was taking on some of the hard rhythm and drive of Chicago. Finally, with the Austin High School gang, a style was born that has been called Chicago style. Later, the Chicago group expanded to include many who were not in the original Austin High gang, but their music had the same Chicago beat and the same wild onion tang. To name a few, there were Jimmy McPartland, Freeman, Pee Wee Russell, Gene Krupa. Eddie Condon, Big Jack Teagarden, Joe Sullivan, and Bobby Haggart, a Chicagoan by association. We'll be right back. How about that? Ladies and gentlemen, we present a Chicago free-for-all.
Dearest pal,